Our question this week comes from Kim Schmieder about her large yucca torii that had three tall individual trunks. This summer, one of the trunks broke in half and was wet inside. Then another trunk broke in half and sounded hollow. What's going on? We reached out to New Mexico landscape architect David Cristiani and John White, garden curator for the Chihuahuan Desert Gardens at the University of Texas, El Paso, to get their thoughts. Both have seen this issue on torii and other large tree-form yuccas. Although it isn't obvious from these photos, both John and David suggest that the culprit could be yucca weevil. Look for frass and exit holes in the trunk. Also look for any cavities or trails that may have been made by other boring insects, whose larvae bore into the trunk and feed on the heart of the plant, making it less stable and more susceptible to decay and breakage. John and David also noted, and I've witnessed this myself, that the problem could just as easily be that the weight of a large limb growing at an angle may become too heavy for the trunk to support. Environmental factors will have an effect on this. Heavy spring rains in central Texas may lead to rapid, weak growth. Also, in an irrigated landscape, regular irrigation and perhaps fertilization may be a factor causing the yucca to grow too fast. In either case, rapid growth often results in a weakened trunk. Much like a teenager who may be a little clumsy at a point when their legs grow a little faster than the rest of their body, rapid growth spurts in desert species, which are more accustomed to a different pattern of rainfall, often become gangly and lose their balance. Yucca are slow growers, so resist the temptation to fertilize and even to irrigate, except during the hottest, longest of dry spells, and even then only sparingly. Plant yucca and other desert species in rocky areas of the garden, perhaps even on berms, and be sure that the soil has good drainage. And don't use bark mulch or other organic mulch around these plants. In short, do everything you can to mimic their native habitat. As we occasionally do, this week we're highlighting a plant that you don't want to cultivate. Ellen Martin spotted this stringy vine strangling her bronze fennel, marjoram, and tomatoes. It doesn't have leaves, but it does have tiny white flowers. Well, we're glad that Ellen got in touch, because this is dodder, a parasitic vine that gets its nourishment by stealing it from other plants. Dodder is an annual vine and is listed as a noxious weed on the official federal list of noxious invasive species. Seeds germinate in spring and the plants flower in late spring to summer. Remove seedlings as they sprout and cut back any mature plants once you notice them. Do not let dodder flower or produce fruit. Since it's an annual, you can use a pre-emergent herbicide, but that will also inhibit the seeds that you want to grow. Thankfully, with diligence, use of any product won't be necessary at all if you remove those seedlings before they have a chance to produce the next generation. Augie will be back soon, and we'd love to hear from you. Visit centraltexasgardener.org to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.